Oh God. What about Alice? She's dead.
A series of murders is terrorizing a city.
I'm putting you on the Jabberwocky case.
No one's heard from Jabberwocky for
10 years.
All the evidence points to one suspect.
Gideon Wood killed Tommy, picked him up, he threw him off this bridge.
And we always said that, John. We never did prove it, though.
But for a cop on the trail of a serial killer.
What did you see out there when you touched the boy?
Do I know you?
Did you see him die?
Every clue leads to new questions.
How do you catch a guy who changes weapons every time he kills?
Every question deepens the mystery.
Off in the lobby an hour ago. No one saw who left it.
It doesn't make any sense, Mick.
I think I can help you.
How do you?
I see things, too.
And every step he takes.
The house. Jabberwocky was in that house.
I know what you're thinking, and you're way off base.
Brings him closer.
Look, the medical examiner found two blood types in that alley.
To the eye of the killer.
I know who was with Alice on the stairs.
Does she haunt you at night?
Kiefer Sutherland.
Invade your dreams?
Henry Cherney.
Screaming at you!
Polly Walker.
You can never get away from that.
Eye of the Killer.
Listen to me, Peter. Don't go taking this matter into your own hands.
Just do my job.
Both Americans, both shot dead.
Welcome to Paris.
But why are you really here? Or is it all classified?
The president's on your private line.
Tell him everything's under control.
Peter Connolly.
The passport, stolen or counterfeit?
Stolen.
Finds the key to a conspiracy.
I don't need to tell anyone about this.
Leads to an old friend.
I'm fast regretting I recommended you for this job, Peter.
And a new love.
Am I embarrassing you?
Wrong verb, actually.
How far are you going to go with this? How dirty are you willing to get?
Dirty as I have.
Lou's disappeared. His wife woke up and he was gone.
Now, a choice must be made.
If he's worthless, kill him.
Between conscience and country.
You're not sleeping with her too, are you?
Between loyalty and the law.
Well, sport. Good luck.
Stay out of trouble.
Everything in the trunk is supposed to be dead.
Salt Lake City.
Oh, it's beautiful, really. But kind of scary at the same time. The people have a strange politeness. An eerie calm. Temporary shelter in a fragile kiss. You just know they all have this stranger inside of them that's dying to get out.
For these four friends,
is that for a little fun?
The stranger inside just escaped.
Why is there a naked dead guy in your living room floor?
We have to call the police.
Wait, no. I didn't just spend 7 years of my life studying my ass off in law school. No police.
They wouldn't find the body. There was nothing left to find.
Now, things were about to get even stranger.
Oops.
Because the truth is stranger than fiction.
Looks like we're two for two.
And this was not in self-defense.
You want to go to a wedding with a body in the trunk?
Two bodies in the trunk.
They thought things couldn't get any worse.
You still gotta settle some business. I'm about to get gag in the trunk. Say 50 grand.
What was I supposed to do? Not kill him would have been good for starters.
What's one more body amongst friends?
As the body count rose, their lives started to unravel.
You sure acting strange.
This is very not good.
Yes, you'll kill her.
What?
What? She's dead.
Just tell me she's not in your trunk. Jerry, stand on her hand.
You notice anything unusual?
Unusual?
Yeah.
No, no.
The truth had become stranger than fiction.
Count Baba.
Dina Meyer, Natasha Gregson-Wagner, Mackenzie Astin, and Todd Field star in Stranger Than Fiction.
Meet Leanne Watson. She's an ideal student. The only thing that stands between her and success is her history teacher.
Mrs. Tingle, she hates me.
But she'll do almost anything to make the grade.
What is this?
Oh, just Tingle's final exam.
Tempting, isn't it?
The smartest girl in school caught cheating. It'll be scandalous.
I'm innocent.
Even the innocent sometimes burn at the stake.
You're doing.
You can't keep treating people the way you do.
No.
Don't be stupid. Put it down.
You lose, Mr. Churner.
Uh-oh. From Kevin Williamson, the writer of Dawson's Creek and Scream, comes a new film that puts three students in a class by themselves, teaching Mrs. Tingle.
What's the matter, Mrs. Tingle? Are you getting a little scared yourself?
Things are just starting to get fun.
Why is it always me that does all the hard graft?
Because you're the one with the shovel.
I want straight edges, you know.
What are you on about? It's pitch bloody black, man. I need some bloody light, man!
Oi! Yes!
Run, man!
A spokesman for Newcastle United had described last night's theft as an act of mindless vandalism.
Mindless? That's bollocks, man. We put a lot of thought into that.
You know what you and me need? A mission.
What are you on about, Jerry, man?
Season tickets.
Don't hand them out on the social, you know. They cost about £500, like, each.
Anything we can think of for making money, we'll do.
I wrote with some of these two. I don't know what it is, but it's not helping our biddies across the road, I know that much.
50p for the guy!
Why, it's only September, man!
Scrap, man, Jerry! The river's full of it, look!
You look like you've been stood the arse end of an elephant, you.
How much do you think people are going to give us for stuff that we've nicked from a shop called Everything's a Pound?
Depends on what it's worth, like.
Run for it!
Next window, please.
What, I'm running the bank.
Sorry?
A woman, the bank!
Next window, please.
You know what we'll get, Sue Woman? When we get our season tickets. Something you and me have never had.
Proper pies?
Have you ever wondered why we are like we are?
What? Bloody hungry and lost.
I mean, what decides, like? You're gonna be brainy. You're not. You're gonna be lucky. You're not. You're gonna have. You're gonna have not.
Deep down, you're still nothing but a bloody angel, aren't you?
Hey, little funny magnet, this like.
This isn't any old funny magnet. It's Alan bloody Shearer's funny magnet.
Julie, he's got a CD player. Stick one in, man. What's he got?
Oh, no, no, Alan. Celine friggin' Dion. Dreams can come and look at me, babe. I'm with you. You know you got to have home.
You know you got to be strong. So then my mother says to me, the whole point of your college education is to meet a nice boy. I just told her it was hard enough to meet a nice girl.
You girls sure you're in the right place?
Me and my friends are gay, you know.
How can you like someone who dresses like a man?
I thought you were a tough feminist. I thought you were just tough.
Well, what do you think now?
Why are you here?
My friend fell off a ladder. We think she had a stroke.
Please, would you tell me if something's wrong?
I'm sorry. Miss Henley passed away.
Did she, leave a will or anything saying that she wanted to give the house to you?
No. You see, I don't think that it's fair that we should have to take her to somebody else's maiden aunt.
Maybe we should adopt. Oh, yeah. Adoption agencies are always so open to alternative family adoptions.
That's true. It'd be quicker if you got me pregnant.
I hate that I can't get you pregnant.
For the internet.
I guarantee you're getting the cream of the crop here.
Professor, he's been married a really long time. His sperm will be really potent.
You're going to be a great mom.
I hope so.
Please adjust your universal translator to the language of your understanding. We will begin in 5 seconds.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Of all the creatures in the universe, none possess the mating ritual as complex as the earthbound human. This one lacks the correct genetic stock. This one just smells funny. This one is just right. To prepare for mating, she sways her hips and flails her behind. Mating is imminent. The male's task is to determine if the female is ready. He will not give up, for the human male is among the horniest of creatures in the known universe. They move toward each other, and they brush lips. But her egg is not in her mouth, and his semen is not in his tongue.
You said you haven't been with that many women.
Yeah, but they were all sluts and drug addicts. Are you ready to take this relationship to the next step?
The male's body tenses with anxiety. All his blood is rushed to his loins.
Yes!
This condition will not pass until he has mated with his female. Is ready. He is ready.
Oh boy.
And at long last, conception! The male is contented. The male is contented as well.
Oh, it's good.
Nervous about the male's reaction, the female tries to mate with her own pack, but that's a whole other movie. One can only feel for them a sense of admiration. It's from these creatures that we have acquired the universal expression.
Nice guys really do finish last.
The mating habits.
You know what they're saying?
That you're the ringleader. That it was all your idea.
You give us who we really want, we'll get you.